Hey guys, what time is it? It's 8:10. I'm sleepy, like, and my brain has been on all day. I've been active all day. Tomorrow's a big day, and I've just been in a sea of ropes trying to get all these done. Cutting. Got more to do. Tying. Bagging. Tomorrow, I am passing off the duty of fulfilling orders of shipping the stuff out. Finally got round to passing it on to a fulfilment centre, which I'm going to drive to in person tomorrow in Bristol, Huboo, and I'm excited to meet them. They've been very helpful so far and very supportive. Just been trying to get everything ready for tomorrow, and I feel like I'm also doing other things as well, but anyway, I can't, it is what it is. I can't complain. It's a good problem to have. I've got to tie the rest of them. I've got to bag all of them. I've got to do all the last of the orders that I'm going to do myself. And I've got to label everything with the quantities and the SKU codes and all this stuff. So anyway, I just thought I'd show you the night before because this room is chaos. And I've just moved into this house recently and it's just been so messy. I've not been able to like really relax in here yet. But once these ropes are out of the way, I might have an actual relax. So I've had Faith in here the last 2 days as well, helping me, because we released a children's rope thanks to the help of Faith. You breathe life into my sawdust. I don't know, it's more just, why would I be touring? Got these eco mailing bags. Apparently there's a few different penguins, so I got 2,000 of the wrong bag. 2,000 of these. Now, I can make it work, but I might try and send some of them back. These are just the little things in businesses, right? Whereas, like, the other bags I use are great. I love the recycled bags we send the ropes in. 9:30. I'm going to go up and pack the orders to send in the morning. Upstairs, I need to pee as well. Like a kid, just holding it in. Right, welcome to the office. Going to set the mood. Little bit, about time. All of these stickers. Handwrite a little thank you. Go into every bag. Set the music. Go. This is my album right now. Been listening to. Nearly 11 o'clock now, just doing the finishing touches. Still got a little bit more to do in the morning, but for the most part I think I'm about ready, so I'm going to get some rest, hopefully. I'm just coming up, 6:07. Got a couple hours before I got to leave, and I'm going to go down and just cut some more ropes just to do the final, to do as much as I can. There we go, pretty full, packed up on my bed, my pillow just in case I need to stay over. Yeah. Look. So there we are, packed up, ready to leave, ready to do my final drop at the post office. I've got some breakfast here, I've managed to squeeze in a workout. I've got 370 bags of ropes. That's probably about 400 ropes, actually, almost exactly, I think. 400 ropes, all cut and tied, hand cut and tied, taken down to Bristol now, so it's like a 2.5-hour drive. So post office, then to Bristol. Whew, big day, rushing around, man. I'm doing this so that I don't have to rush, but I don't know if you get to not doing something by doing it, you know. Okay, I've just dropped off now at Huboo. It's a bit of a all too easy. I just drove up to the back entrance, offloaded my boxes and there they are.
Huboo.
Been great so far. Now I'm going to go check out the other site and meet Alex, who sort of helped me on board. Cool, so I've just driven 20 minutes away to their other site. I don't know what the one was. I don't know if this is the fulfillment center, but that's the sorting center, or that was the fulfillment center, and this is where some of the staff work. Anyway, I wanted to meet the people and look around, so we're going to head in now and check it out. Cool.
Even the directors, even C-suite.
Yeah.
As you can see, you've got all the bits and pieces.
It's amazing. This is how it's going to be. What's going on there then? So, I've just had a look around the fulfillment centre. I first went to the goods inn that I dropped the stuff off, and then it gets sorted there and it will get sent to the fulfillment. But I wanted to come and look around. Basically, as the business is growing and rope flow practice is taking off and more of you people are getting into this wonderful, what a beautiful practice this is, it's taking more and more of my time every day. And so the more time I'm spent running the business in the back end and maintaining that stuff, the less time I'm actually able to do the things I truly want to do. Now, I don't mind at all packing and sending ropes to you guys. Like, I actually, it's quite a meditative task. It's quite relaxing, actually. But it's got to a point when I have to, as my business is growing, look at the things that I can pass certain tasks off to other people so that I can spend more time doing the things I actually enjoy. And what I really enjoy is spreading this practice, is making content on YouTube, sharing, you know, tutorials and patterns and videos about it. And I want to teach people more in person as well, you know, and also want to spend time on self-reflection and introspection. And This is the most busiest I've been in my adult life these last few months. It's been the most I've ever worked on a job in my life. And so looking, I literally Googled Fulfillment Centres UK, had a look at who was there, had a look at who seemed to align with how I feel, and it just seemed like Huboo was a really good fit. Walking around today, Alex showed me around the site, seeing everyone smiling, everyone's happy. Like, if I just came out of school and I lived by here, I would definitely want a job at a place like this. And I, as this practice grows, as rope flow grows, you know, I'm grateful to have met David Weck and to have learned it from him. This is still in its infancy. And so the more, you know, even looking at a place like this, I love, as I'm growing in business, as I love looking at other businesses and I love looking at infrastructures and logistics and what they've done here, like literally the word logistical nightmare is like a real phrase for a reason, because things can be, and this is a logistical, it can be a nightmare or a dream. Like what they've done here, it's very impressive how the operating system of everything behind the scenes actually works for a fulfillment center to take in a small business, because I'm such a small business, you know, 5 to 10, maybe 20 orders on a really good day I'm doing per day. That's not much at all for someone like this. And for them to take me in, and for Alex to be so helpful, and that Will is going to onboard me, and like to meet the people that are actually going to run it for such, I mean, such a small business, that's so nice to feel like it's not just some dead empty warehouse, you know, soulless place. So yeah, I'm grateful to be able to pass on my job and come and meet the people in person that are going to take on any part of this business. I want to know the kind of people that are helping to those roles, because I don't want to just give it off, like I say, to something soulless, just to, like, I won't give examples, but anyway, I wanted to be involved with that side of business still. So this is one of the jobs I could pass off. This practice is going so far, I've said it in the past to someone, like, this has the potential to be as big as almost something like yoga. Like, and if someone's felt rope flow, I think they would completely get that. If someone's never tried it and they hear me say that, they might think that sounds exaggerative or cocky or something like that. But if you've experienced it, like, this is such a unique practice that's innate. When running business, people say you need to have an avatar. What's your person that you're directing what you're selling to? And it's been so hard. I can't come up with an avatar for rope flow. It's anyone with a spine that's open-minded to try it, you know. Because there's so many different people. You get children that love it. I get 70-year-olds, you know, doing the program on my app and loving it. And people that are athletes, people that are into breath work and meditation. And if you're in the body and you want a physical practice, I don't know. Don't need to get into that explanation. But it's a wonderful thing. And to be able to set up systems myself and be organized myself to be able to get this to more people more efficiently, and then to be able to have more time for me to create more content for you guys. It's a step in the right direction, and it's a win-win for everyone involved, it feels like. So yeah, I'm here. It's a big day for Way of the Rope. That's why I wanted to it's a big step and a milestone in the Way of the Rope chapter of the journey of what I'm doing here. And so I just wanted to share this moment for anyone that cares at all. I want to be a bit more open about the business and the back end of this stuff, because I like when other people do share, you know, are very open and transparent about how they run businesses. So I wanted to maybe share a moment, a milestone in the Way of the Rope journey. And so we'll see what changes from here, if anything changes, if nothing changes, if things get busier and I just have to work on other things. But hopefully I'm going to have more free time for myself, importantly, and equally importantly is to make stuff that helps other people as well. So thanks for watching, thanks for following this journey up until now. Stay tuned for the future, it's quite an exciting time. And yeah, bless you all, see you in the next video.